Hello everyone. In this video, I'll discuss some of the most important questions commonly asked in digital design interviews. Specifically, what are setup and hold time constraints, and how do they impact the performance and robustness of digital circuits? So let's get started. First, let's revisit some basic definitions related to flip-flop timing, such as setup time, hold time, and clock to queue delay. Setup time is the minimum time duration that the input data at the flip-flop must be stable before the active edge of the clock occurs. Hold time is the minimum duration required for the input data to be stable after the active edge of the clock. And clock to queue delay is the time it takes for the flip-flop output queue to be stable at a new value after the active edge of the clock. Violating setup and hold time means that an incorrect data may get stored in the flip-flop. Another important definition we must be familiar to understand setup and hold time constraints is contamination delay and propagation delay of a block. Let's consider a block with one or more inputs and outputs. When an input changes, the output doesn't react immediately. It takes some time for the signal to propagate through the circuit and settle to a stable logic. This gives rise to two timing parameters: contamination delay, denoted as T sub CD logic, and propagation delay, denoted by T sub PD logic. Contamination delay is the earliest time after an input change that the output may begin to change, while propagation delay is the maximum time after an input change for the output to settle to its final value. For example, let's say input A changes from high to low or vice versa. Over here, we don't care about the logic level. We are only interested that it changes, not what its value is. In response to the input, the output O changes. It may begin to respond to the input after a time duration that is contamination delay, denoted as T sub CD logic, and eventually settles to a correct final value within T sub PD logic, which is the propagation delay. Now that we know these basic definitions, it's time to talk about timing constraints. Timing constraints in digital circuits refer to the timing checks between related flops, specifically the launch flop and the capture flop. These constraints must be satisfied to ensure the correct and reliable operation in design. If the constraints are not met, the data launched from the launch flop may not arrive at the capture flop at the correct time relative to the clock signal. As a result, the capture flop may latch incorrect data, leading to functional errors in the circuit. There are two primary timing constraints between the launch flop and the capture flop. First is setup time constraint. This constraint ensures that the data launched from the launch flop arrives at the capture flop early enough to satisfy its setup time requirement before the active clock edge. The second constraint is hold time constraint. This constraint ensures that the data at the input of the capture flop remains stable for a short duration after the clock edge, satisfying hold time requirement. Together, these constraints ensure that the data is propagated correctly between the sequential elements. Let's go over the setup constraint in detail. In the figure shown over here, there are two flip-flops: FF0 launch flip-flop and FF1 capture flip-flop. We would analyze the data flow between the flops and understand the condition under which the data launched from the input of FF0 at the launch clock edge is correctly captured by FF1 at the capture clock edge. The waveform over here illustrates the clock signal with time period T. The launch clock edge and the capture clock edge are shown with green arrows. When the active clock edge occurs in FF0, the data present at its input becomes available at output Q after clock to queue delay. This data then propagates through combinational logic, which introduces an additional propagation delay, TPD logic. Now let's focus over here. If T setup time is the setup time of FF1, then the condition for the correct data capture is that the data arriving at the input of FF1 must be stable at least T setup time before the capture clock edge. In summary, for successful data capture, the total delay from FF0 to FF1, which includes clock to queue delay and propagation delay, must satisfy the setup time requirement of FF1 relative to the clock period. Putting it all together, the condition can be written as T minus T clock to queue minus TPD logic must be greater than T setup time, which is shown over here, or equivalently, T, that is the time period of clock, must be greater than T clock to queue plus TPD logic plus T setup. This constraint defines the minimum clock period required for correct operation of sequential circuit. Consequently, it determines the maximum clock frequency at which the design can operate reliably. In this discussion so far, we have assumed that there is no clock skew or jitter. I will explain how clock skew and jitter affect this timing constraint in a later video. Now let's apply the setup time constraint in an example. Suppose we have to find out the maximum operating frequency of a system where the critical path delay, that is TPD logic, is 1.2 nanosecond, setup time is 50 picosecond, and clock to queue is 100 picosecond. Using the setup constraint equation, time period T must be greater than or equal to 1.2 plus 0.05 plus 0.1, which gives the maximum operating frequency of this design as 740 megahertz. Now let's look at hold time constraint. To determine the hold time constraint, we examine the fastest possible path from the launch flop to the input of the capture flop. For the data to be captured reliably in capture flip-flop, the minimum delay from the launch flip-flop input to the capture flip-flop input must be greater than the hold time of the capture flip-flop. The data launched from the D input of the launch flip-flop FF0 appears at its output Q after a minimum delay of DCD register, that is the contamination delay of the flip-flop. This data then propagates through the combinational logic with minimum delay of TCD logic. The sum of these two delays, that is TCD register and TCD logic, must be greater than the hold time. This is the hold time constraint. This can be written in expression as TCD register plus TCD logic must be greater than T hold. This constraint ensures that the data at the D input of the capture flip-flop remains stable for at least the hold time after the clock edge. If any path in the design is too fast, it may violate this condition, meaning the data could change too soon after the clock edge, leading to hold time violation or race condition, where the output of the capture flip-flop becomes unpredictable. So this is all for this video. I hope this helps you to understand setup and hold constraints in digital design.